Okay, good morning student. Let's start about your AutoCAD software. After downloading AutoCAD software, you will see this is your icon of AutoCAD. To open the software, first you select this icon by left clicking and then press enter. And see, your AutoCAD screen is open. In the above, there is AutoCAD icon and the it is written AutoCAD 2010 drawing 1.dwg. It means AutoCAD is running here in 2010 version, and drawing 1 it is its file name, and .dwg it is extension. You can rename your drawing file drawing 1 by drawing 2, anything, any words, but .dwg is compulsory every time. So next is your menu bar, and in the below there is command line, and this is your status bar, and this black screen is your workspace, and this is your there is your crosshair. You see this is plus sign, this is called crosshair. If you move your mouse, the crosshair will move. You can save your drawing. You go to the file, then click as save as, then click at desktop, and you can rename your drawing one by class 1 and save. See, drawing 1 has been changed in class 1.dwg. Now you can select your workspace by clicking here. There is 2D drafting and annotation. You can select AutoCAD Classic, 3D modeling, anything. But here I am doing with 2D drafting and annotation. Next is status bar. This is your status bar. You see some icon is blue and some icon is black. The blue icon indicates that these icons are on. If you press this icon by left clicking, it will off. So here polar is off. It is written here that polar off. If you click O snap, it means object snap. You click, then object snap is off. Again you click at object snap, then object snap is on, and click at polar, the polar is on, and then you click at ortho, then ortho is on. So this is your status bar. And what is the utility of this status bar? First you select the ortho mode. If you click at ortho mode, then you can draw the horizontal and vertical line only. You cannot draw inclined line. Okay, so to draw the line, you in the command line, you go to the command line and write line and press enter. So you have to specify your first point. I am clicking anywhere of the screen, then you drag the mouse, you see this is increasing horizontally, and if you drag the mouse in above, this is your vertical line. Okay, so you can draw the line horizontal and vertical when the ortho mode is on, but you cannot draw inclined line. Now you press enter or right click. Now you press the ortho off. Now you go to the command line and type line and press enter. Now is ortho mode is off, and you can draw inclined line. I am clicking here. You see, this is your inclined line when the ortho mode is off. So this is the utility of ortho. Next is your O snap. O snap means object snap. Suppose I am I want to draw a line from this corner to this corner. So what we'll do in the command line, we'll type line and press enter. Now you click at this point and then click at this point. Now you zoom the drawing. You see this point actually not started from this corner. This line has not started this corner. You see. So to remove this problem, O snap or object snap is necessary. Now you click at O snap button. So O snap is on. Now you go to the line and click this corner. You see there is a endpoint indicator by orange color. Now click here and click at this point and right click, enter. Now see the point actually start from this point to this point. So this is very important. O snap, only corner point is not. You can draw from this midpoint to midpoint line. You go to the line menu and you see this is your midpoint. This is indicating midpoint. You see there is written midpoint. Now click here and click here. This is the midpoint of this line, vertical line. Now click here, right click, enter. So actually this is the function of AutoCAD OSnap. Next is dynamic input. Dynamic input, what is the utility? You go to the line command and click here. You see in the cursor or crosshair there is nothing is written. Nothing means its length, its angle of this line or coordinate, nothing is written. Now you click at dynamic input button. Now go to the line command. Now click here and you see the line is indicating this is 17 degree angle and the coordinate is 416. This starting point is 416. Okay, so this is the utility of dynamic input. Now click, this is dynamic input is off. Now go to the line. Now see nothing is indicating its angle, length, coordinate, nothing is indicating. Okay, this is the dynamic input button. Next is your line command. We can draw line by various process. First is direct distance entry method. What is it? Now I am minimizing this button. This is another screen. Direct distance entry system. You go to the line. Now click anywhere of the screen and you see you can draw inclined line. Now you press the ortho on. By ortho on you can draw direct distance entry. It means you can draw horizontal and vertical line very easily. Go to the line command, click here and you type the length of this line 50 and press enter. So this is the length of 50 unit of a line. Again you go to the line, click anywhere and you put the value 100 of this vertical line. Press enter. So this is the direct distance entry method. Direct distance entry method is very easy, but there is another problem that you cannot draw inclined line by direct distance entry method, because at that time ortho mode is off and if you click at line then you cannot draw. Now we will learn how can I apply the color in my drawing and text. For that, you select the object and go to this properties toolbar where all the colors are given. You can select any color and press enter. You can select the color of this dimension line also. You select the dimension line and click another color and press escape menu. You can select colors from this palette. You can select any color. I'm selecting suppose this one. Click OK. Now I want to change this color of this drawing. Now select the drawing, go to the color menu bar, select color, select this one and OK. We can change the line. Suppose this is your continuous line and we can change it into dash line or center line. How will do? You go to the bilayer option and see here is continuous line is given. You select others, then load, then select this one, dash line, click OK and again OK. Now you go to the bilayer, then select this dash line and go to the line toolbar and draw this line. This is your dash line. You can draw center line also. Go to the bilayer, then others, then load, select this one, center line, OK. Now select this one and go to the line, again draw this line. This is your center line. You can change the thickness of this line. Select this one, draw line. You can draw thick line. The thickness of this line is more than the previous one. You click at line weight and see the thickness of line is increased. Okay. Now we will learn how we will set up our page for the drawing in AutoCAD. For that, in the command line you type units and press enter. See, this dialog box is open. You go to the decimal unit. You can select engineering, architecture, anything, but I am selecting here decimal, then click millimeter and then OK. Next, in the command line you type limits and press enter, specifying the lower left corner. This is your lower left corner and this is your upper right corner. In the lower left corner you write 0, 0, this is the coordinate value, and the upper right corner I am taking here 297, 210 and press enter. Next you type zoom command. After pressing zoom you select all and press enter. Next is your MV setup command. MV setup, press enter, then you write no for model space and for paper space you write yes. So I am selecting no for model space. Next is your metric. You select metric because I am selecting the unit millimeter, so I am clicking metric. Next is scale factor. If you want to draw your drawing in 1:1 ratio, so you press 1. If you want to enlarge your drawing then write 2, 3, 4 anything. And if you draw in your drawing in small unit, so you can write 0.5, 0.3, anything. So I'm selecting here 1 for 1:1 scale. Now the paper width, I'm selecting 297, then is height 210. Now see, this margin has been created. You can draw anything inside this box. Now I'm going to draw toolbar and clicking at line command. Now selecting I'm here. Now I'm giving the ortho mode is on and giving the value of line is 100 for the horizontal line. 0 degree means horizontal line. Press enter. Now go to the vertical position. Vertical line length I'm putting 50. Press enter. Then again horizontal line in opposite direction, it means 180 degree. I'm giving the value again 70. And if we press C or close, C means close, then the drawing will be close. This is, I have drawn this drawing by direct entry system. Now I have to give the dimension. So you go to the dimension toolbar, then linear. After clicking linear, you click at OSnap button. This OSnap is on. Now click at this point and click at this point and drag your mouse in the below. The dimension is given. You see this length is given 100. Again you go to the dimension and linear, click here and here. Again, now I have to give this incline line. So for the horizontal and vertical line I am selecting linear, but for the incline line I have to go align. Okay, now click at this point and this point. So this is the length of this incline line. And if we want to give the angle of this object, so go to the dimension and click at angular. Now select this line and this line and drag your mouse in suitable position and see the value is 59 degree. Again I am giving the dimension of vertical line. Now select this one and this one. See, this is your 90 degree. You can select this linear option from here, align in angular, linear, etc. If you draw some circle or arc, and giving the some arc. Now you go to the dimension and radius. Select the arc and see the radius is given. If we want to give the diameter of this circle, go to the dimension, then click at diameter. Select the circle in this way. So this is the procedure of giving dimension of the object. you can select the center mark option and put the center mark of the any circle. Suppose you draw a circle, go to the draw, sorry, dimension, and then center mark. Now select the circle, you see the center mark is available. In this way we can put the dimension of the object very easily. Suppose I am drawing a object. And go to the dimension and you go to the baseline.